Good morning, students. Today from your first flat book, we are doing chapter number 3, two stories about flying. We are doing with the second story, Black Aeroplane, written by Frederick Forsyth. Frederick Forsyth was a British novelist, journalist, former spy, and occasional political commentator. He is best known for thrillers such as The Day of the Jackal, The Dogs of War, The Afghan, The Fist of God, etc. Frederick Forsyth describes quite a unique but mysterious experience during his flight from Paris to London. A pilot is lost in storm clouds. Does he arrive safe? Who helps him? So let's read the story and find out. The Black Aeroplane. The moon was coming up in the east behind me and stars were shining in the clear sky above me. So the narrator, he is flying and he says that as he is flying, he sees that the sky is very clear and the moon is coming up, rising up from the east. And he says that there are twinkling stars. The stars are shining. There wasn't a cloud in the sky. It was a clear sky. There wasn't any cloud. I was happy to be alone high up above the sleeping countryside. And he says as he's flying his aeroplane, he's happy. He's all happy to be alone high up as the country, as it is the night time, the countryside is sleeping. I was flying my own Dakota aeroplane over France back to England. So the narrator was flying his old Dakota aeroplane and he's flying from where? He's flying from France to England. I was dreaming of my holiday and looking forward to being with my family. So narrator wishes that he would be going back to his family in England and he would be enjoying his holiday, his stay there along with the family members. I looked at my watch, 1:30 in the morning. So it was 1:30 and he notices the time. I should call Paris control soon, I thought. So the narrator who is flying all alone in his aeroplane, Dakota aeroplane, he thought of getting connected to Paris control. As I looked down past the nose of the aeroplane, I saw the lights of a big city in front of me. I switched on the radio and said, so he notices from the aeroplane the city lights and he switches on the radio to get connected to Paris control. And he said, Paris control, Dakota DS088 here. Can you hear me? I'm on my way to England. Over. So he gets connected to Paris control and he informs that he is in Dakota DS088 and then he waits for the instruction. He informs that he is on his way to England. The voice from the radio answered me immediately. DS088, I can hear you. You ought to turn 12 degrees west now. DS088, over. So when he got connected to the radio asking for instructions that he is on his way to England, the voice from the radio answered that he has to take the course of 12 degrees west. And the person informed that to turn 12 degrees west. DS088. So the person informed so and it said over. That is, the call was over. I checked the map and the compass, switched over to my second and last fuel tank and turned the Dakota 12 degrees west towards England. So the narrator, he checks on the map and he checks the compass. Compass is an instrument consisting of a magnetized needle to show north and south direction. So he checks upon map and compass. Switched over to my second and last fuel tank. So he was banking upon the fuel tank that was the only fuel tank that he was having, the last fuel tank, and turned the Dakota 12 degrees west towards England. And he followed the instructions given to him that he had to head towards 12 degrees west direction to go to England. I will be in time for breakfast, I thought. A good big English breakfast. Everything was going well. It was an easy flight. So the narrator thought that everything was going well for him. It was an easy flight and he thought that he would be with his family and he would be in time for big English breakfast. So he was making dreams to be with his family for the holiday, of the breakfast. Everything he was planning and things were going pretty smooth for him. Paris was about 150 kilometers behind me when I saw the clouds, storm clouds. So the narrator had already left Paris. It was 150 kilometers away behind him. And then he notices storm clouds in front of him. They were huge. They looked like black mountains standing in front of me across the sky. And then the narrator compares the storms with the black mountains. They were huge and black and they were across the sky. I knew I could not fly up and over them and I did not have enough fuel to fly around them to the north or south. And narrator knew it would be very unsafe to travel and especially he couldn't pass them as it was impossible to go above them or escape them when he did not have enough amount of fuel left with him to go to north or to south direction. I ought to go back to Paris, I thought, but I wanted to get home. I wanted that breakfast. Now throughout the day he had been planning to go home. He had been planning to be with the family, to enjoy that English breakfast of sausages, of bacon, of eggs. And he thought that I ought to go back to Paris. The right idea would be to go to Paris, but throughout the day he had been dreaming to be with his family and enjoy the breakfast. I will take the risk, I thought, and flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. And then the narrator, he took the risk and the plane went straight into the storm. Inside the clouds, everything was suddenly black. It was impossible to see anything outside the aeroplane. And when he was inside the clouds, everything looked black inside the mountains of clouds. And he could not see anything outside the aeroplane. The old aeroplane jumped and twisted in the air. I looked at the compass. I couldn't believe my eyes. The compass were turning round and round and round. It was dead. It would not work. The other instruments were suddenly dead too. I tried the radio. So the narrator who had taken the old Dakota aeroplane into the storm because he thought that going to Paris with a small amount of fuel would be a wrong. So he took the risk and moved ahead in the black storm clouds so that he could reach to his home. And then when he was in the mountain of clouds, the aeroplane started jumping and twisting in the air. He had a look at the compass, but the compass was not working. He saw the other instruments, they were also dead too. So he tried the radio to connect it to the Paris control. Paris control, Paris control, can you hear me? So he's trying to connect to the radio to talk to Paris control for some help, some answer. There was no answer. The radio was dead too. I had no radio, no compass, and I could not see where I was. I was lost in the storm. And then his instruments are not working. The radio is not working. He could not get any help from the radio. He didn't know where he was. He was very helpless. He was in a hopeless situation with no radio getting connected, no compass working, nothing in his favor. So he did not know what he should do. I was lost in the storm and he was altogether in a hopeless situation and in a helpless state.